I'm Captain Monica Rochester. I'm the Coast Guard Sector Commander for Los Angeles Long Beach. And with me is the Unified Command for the Ventura County Fire Department, the Santa Barbara County Fire, as well as the National Park Service. Coast Guard and partner agencies have responded to a vessel fire near Santa Cruz Island this morning at 0330, which is 3:30 a.m. Coast Guard Sector Los Angeles Long Beach watchstanders overheard a mayday call via channel 16 of an engulfed 75-foot commercial diving vessel with 39 people aboard. Crews from the Coast Guard, Santa Barbara Fire Department, Ventura County Fire Department, and the Vessel Assist have responded. Fire department crews were fighting the fire when the vessel sank 20 yards offshore in 64 feet of water. Five people were evacuated aboard a Good Samaritan pleasure craft known as the Great Escape. Currently, 34 people aboard the vessel are unaccounted for. Watchstanders at Coast Guard Sector Los Angeles Long Beach launched two Coast Guard Station Channel Islands Harbor 45-foot response boat medium crews, a Coast Guard Air Station San Francisco forward operating base Magoo Dolphin MH-65 helicopter crew, a Coast Guard Air Station San Diego MH-60 Jayhawk helicopter crew, and a Coast Guard cutter Narwhal. The vessel currently has a portion of the bow sticking out of the water. Those are my comments at this time. Ventura County, would you like to make a comment?
Dustin Gardner, Ventura County Fire Department. We've been in Unified Command since this morning at 0330 with the United States Coast Guard, Channel Islands Harbor, Ventura, and it will continue to be a unified effort as we switch to Santa Barbara County Sheriff and Santa Barbara County Fire as the incident goes on and we go into a recovery mode.
So there is no chance of, because I'm in recovery mode, there's no chance of further rescues?
Presently, the Coast Guard has full efforts in a response posture right now. We are currently still in the response phase.
Are there divers in the water that are looking in the wreckage?
I don't have any additional information regarding that at this time.
What is response effort?
Response search and rescue activities, yes ma'am.
So what can they be doing at this point?
Right now they're conducting shoreline searches for any available survivors.
Can you give some insight then? What is the distance from where the boat was to the shoreline?
It's approximately 20 yards from my last brief.
So at this point, no word of anyone who made it to shore otherwise?
I don't have any additional information at this time. It's 34 unaccounted for folks on board.
Are there divers in the water?
I can't answer that question. I don't have that information.
Is the boat operator at any
distance? One question at a time, please. I'm sorry?
Is the boat operator at any distance? Have any violations? Have you got to check that?
The vessel has been in full compliance. We are working deliberately with the vessel owner operator who is with us at this time, working on a plan to conduct further assistance for his vessel. Yes, sir. It's at Platts Harbor, I believe. Isn't that correct, Ranger? Platts Harbor, 20 yards off of Platts Harbor on the north side of Santa Cruz Island.
I apologize if this is redundant. The fire, you must have some additional information. Was this something that started small? Was there an explosion that was quick and out of nowhere?
The only mayday call we received was the vessel was engulfed in flames. That's all we received.
About how long was it between that initial call and the time crews were able to arrive?
I don't have that for you right now, but I can get that for you.
How was the trailer being heard of 34 and then 33?
It's 34 unaccounted for people on board.
How was the crew able to get off?
The crew was actually already awake and on the bridge, and they jumped off.
And to clarify, five crew members, were there only five crew members, meaning all crew made it off?
Five crew members on board.
And were they all awake at the time?
They were awake at the time.
Did the crew try to help the other?
I don't have any additional information regarding that.
You mentioned the Great Escape, because we've seen things that were printed Great Escape, but we saw some shirts that said Great Escape.
I believe it's Grape, G-R-A-P-E, Escape.
That was a rescue vessel. Those were not crew members.
It's a Good Samaritan. What we call a Good Samaritan is a person that offered their services to help.
So we see a gentleman wearing a Great Escape shirt, and he's not on the boat, but
simply a Good Samaritan that helped the situation.
Captain, do you know where all of the passengers, as opposed to crew, below below decks on the vessel?
My understanding, or the report I received, they were below decks asleep.
Now, have you received any witness accounts that anybody was able to get above deck from below decks?
I don't have any additional information on that, sir.
And there are no witness accounts of anybody other than the five crew members in the water?
I don't have any additional information. And if you will, we're going to go ahead and continue our research, our response search efforts. So with that, I'll close out this this brief. Thank you. Certainly, it's R-O-C-H-E-S-T-E-R.
All right, that is Captain Monica Rochester, a U.S. Coast Guard. So the new information here, there are 34 people unaccounted for. Previously, that number was 33. There were 39 people aboard. We're now hearing that all five crew members were able to jump off the ship when the fire took place. They were awake and aboard the bridge, and that there is a Good Samaritan vessel, called the Great Escape, that was able to quickly get to at least those five folks and rescue them.
What we were hearing from the Coast Guard is the crew members, five of those crew members were